The room is full of milkmen, some of whom are very old.
This man is Ernest Scribbler, manufacturer of jokes. In a few moments, he will think of the funniest joke in the world, and as a result, he will die laughing. It was obvious the joke was lethal. No one could read it and live. Scribbler's mother, alarmed by the unusual sounds of merriment, entered the room and found what was apparently a suicide note.
The war against the Hun continues, and as Britain's brave boys battle against the Boche, their leaders are on the lookout for new breakthroughs that could provide the ultimate weapon in the war against the Hun. And here, in this little house in Finchley, they think maybe they've found it. It's a joke so deadly, it could have Fritz's forces falling about.
Tests on Salisbury Plain confirm the joke's devastating effectiveness at a range of up to 50 yards.
Winter of 43, we had translators working in joke-proof conditions to try and manufacture a German version of the joke. They worked on one word each for greater safety. One of them saw two words by mistake and had to spend several weeks in hospital, but apart from that, things went ahead pretty fast, and by January, we had the joke in a form which our troops couldn't understand, but which the Germans could.
So, on July the 8th, 1944, the joke was first told to the enemy in the Ardennes.
Squad! Tell the...
In action, it was deadly. German casualties were appalling.
It was a fantastic success, over 80,000 times as powerful as Britain's great pre-war joke, which was used at Munich, and one which Hitler couldn't match.
Heute der Jugend dafür stehlen!
Wie ein Feierabend!